Whatever you're selling, we're not buying. This is the 10th call from you guys today. We're on the do not call list.
I'm not a telemarketer.
Oh, sorry. Hi.
Hello. Who is this?
This is Nathan.
I'm sorry. I must have missed that.
Oh. Okay, well, you reach 569133. I'm guessing you're calling a number in that zone.
Yes, in that zone, as you would put it. That's exactly the number I was calling. Why are you in my mother's house?
Your mother's house? My mom's the only mother here.
Well, 569-1383, that's my mother's phone number.
She must have changed numbers.
No, I can promise you, that's been her number since 1948.
Wait, what?
I said that's been her number since 1948. Is something wrong? Well, yes.
That noise. It sounds like a...
Like a train? Yes, I'm at Central Station.
You can't be there. That station's been shut down since the 70s.
Oh. So, you're a seer now.
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, you're telling me I'm at a station that will close down in 17 years.
No. It's been closed since the 70s.
What game are you playing?
I'm not. You better redial.
But I didn't dial wrong.
Look, you're obviously playing some kind of weird prank, calling from an abandoned station.
I should be saying the same thing to you, mister. I can foresee when stations close down.
Wow, you telemarketers are pretty creative.
I'm not a telemarketer. Don't you know how hard it is to get those jobs?
It is a competitive scene. This is the 21st century, and most people have cell phones with call block.
Nathan, it's 1953. That's the 20th century.
Wow. A call from 1953 to 2018. I'm so scared. Ha ha. Okay, you won. You got me. Now go pull the prank on someone who cares.
If anyone's pulling a prank, it's you.
I'm not. I only use this line on Sundays, and that's for Grandma. So I'm sorry to say, but...
I'm sorry. But I have better things to do, beginning with calling my mother.
And I'm just waiting for a call from my girl. Just waiting for a call.
A transmission from Mars?
Oh, you're hilarious, old timer.
You really believe you live in the future, don't you?
Only if you're serious about living in the 50s.
All right.
All right?
Impress me. Tell me about 2000 and something. Do you take a flying saucer to work?
Fine. You want to continue this game? Let's continue. There are 7 billion people on the planet now. Global climate is getting worse and worse. Technology has evolved so phones are small enough to fit in your pocket.
In your pocket? So, people walk around all day with landlines wherever they go?
Yeah, don't even get me started on video games.
Have there been any more world wars?
Fine. Just the two. There have been a few close calls, but nothing ever happened again.
That's somehow comforting, even if I don't believe all this.
Hey, you never gave me your name.
Well, you never asked.
So pranksters not give out names anymore?
I told you I'm not a prankster. My name is Diane. Diane Flint Watson.
Nathan Grimm. I shake your hand, but...
It's still nice to meet you.
Likewise.
Well, since I've got your name now, is there anything you want to know about your future?
How so?
I can look you up. By name on the internet if there's anything you'd like to know about, I don't know, the next few years of your life.
Excuse me, what's the internet?
It's kind of a network of information all over the world. Anyone with a computer can look up any information.
Anybody's information?
Yeah. I can tell you how old you'll grow, if you'll ever get any kids.
You can stop right there.
Whoa, sorry. Something I said?
No. I'm sorry. Now that you mention it, I don't think I have the heart to know what my future holds.
I thought you didn't believe in any of this.
Like you do?
Coming around.
Who would go to such lengths for a hoax?
Must be some kind of fate at work.
It's only fate if someone knows the future. I'd like to believe that I have a choice in whatever path I choose.
I can respect that.
So you're not...
Googling you? No, I'm not looking you up. I'll respect your privacy.
Thank you.
Why don't you tell me about 1953?
Well, I won't lie to you. It's been 8 years since the last Great War, and we're still reeling from it. But we're starting over. We're celebrating by having lots of children.
Does that include you?
No. It's been about a year, but we're just not there yet.
Well, at least someone gets the idea of not there yet.
I'm sorry?
Oh, sorry. Just thinking out loud.
Nathan, I appreciate you respecting my privacy, but I simply cannot do the same when you seem upset. You are upset, aren't you?
Would you like to talk about it?
What makes you think I'd share personal issues with a stranger?
Well, everyone needs someone to talk to. Not everyone has that luxury.
Well, my...
I don't know. Okay, my girlfriend... She broke up with me last night.
I'm so sorry. May I ask what happened?
I don't know. We started going out a few months ago, but... She's just kind of... I don't know. She's different. We don't have the same views, to put it lightly. She wanted to take a big step forward, but... It just didn't feel right. That probably doesn't make me sound like the good guy, huh?
No, I wouldn't say that. You just don't want to settle. You're looking for something that feels real without doubts. And she may not be that person.
I have to give you credit for that.
I'll take that as a compliment.
Still,
kind of surprising that dating can last so long in the future. After 3 months, if I were her, I would have expected you to have proposed.
Now that sounds like 1953 to me.
Of course. Maybe that's the rebel.
What are you talking about? Diane? Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
What's going on?
It's Christian.
Who's?
My husband. He hit me last night. I think my ribs are bruised and they hurt.
That son of a... Well,
that was...
No, it's okay. Christian was fine when we were dating, but it's been over a year now, and I think I'm really starting to get to know him.
You settled?
Mm-hmm.
Maybe that is the problem.
If you and Christian lived in my time, he'd never get away with something like that.
If only I did live in your time. Nathan, I'm not saying Sinatra did not have a good voice. I'm just not going to pay good money for a post-salad album, even from him.
It's not going to be a post-salad album, Diane. It's going to be a comeback.
Are you Googling this?
I don't have to. All I could hear from my dad growing up was, "Lately, I seem to walk as though I had wings."
That does sound like Frank Sinatra, I'll grant you. Humor me. What will this new album be called?
Songs for Young Lovers. Still with me?
I am, but...
Is there a lineup outside?
I only have enough change for the train fare.
Oh. Okay, yeah, I hear you.
It's not that I'm done with you.
No, it's okay.
This has been one of the best afternoons I've had in a while.
You don't have to.
I don't know if we'll ever speak again. This anomaly in space-time, it may just be a one-off.
I don't know how I'm gonna go home to Christian tonight.
Maybe you shouldn't.
I mean, I think you can do a lot better for yourself.
Are you suggesting a divorce?
I know that's not common in your time, but you deserve better. I'm just saying, you're not happy with Christian, and I
can figure this out.
Nathan, I have to go.
Oh.
I wish we had more time.
I do too.
How about this? Let's try something. Where are you at this moment?
You know where I am. I'm at MSC Station.
Okay, keep the line going. Give me 20 minutes. If you don't see me by then, well...
It'll never work.
Well, what if it does? Just... Maybe this anomaly doesn't have to just be over the phone. But if it is... Just keep the call going.
I don't know if I have 20 minutes. Just
hurry.
I will.